Hey guys, today we're doing a preventive maintenance on a changeout we did about 6 months ago. So this is the first PM on it, and my first chance to come back and check and see how it's doing. Here we go. Well, we made it up here. I see one little issue with that SS2 over there. Algae tablets in here because we may ruin our air conditioner. Every month of the year, even in the middle of winter. Plus, I want to get a look at this coil. Coil looks nice and clean. All right, I am jumping from red to white. All right, there go my heat strips. Wondering why we're getting some water right here. And there's why. What I was pointing out was this right here. That looks like it might not be glued. This right here feels like it's really loose. Let's go get some glue and glue that in. Everything else seems to be glued. I don't know why this isn't. And I tell you what, forgive me now, the fumes get to me a little bit. I'm going to go ahead and, I don't glue these, But I'm gonna go ahead and glue this one. All right, I have it set to cool inside. It's actually kind of cool out here today. I mean, abnormally cool for this time of year. Got us some dead frogs. All right, let's. Looks like we're using orange for blue. Because I got it set to cool, when I jump this out, I'm not gonna satisfy my thermostat. Let me see, while I got the power off, let me check a few things. Helps if I turn my meter on. All right, this is supposed to be a 45 and 7.5. Oh, that felt loose. Now let's swap this over to microfarads. Seven point four four, 45.66. So those are good. All right, next is to check pressures while it's running, and then I'm gonna test defrost. Tight. These are realize a lot of people down here in the south have heat pumps, but up north they may not. Your high side's going to be here, and this is true suction. This is always a liquid line. And then when it's running in heat, this is hot gas. That's liquid. Always liquid. And when it's running in cooling, this is your cool suction. See what temperature is out here. It's kind of low for this time of year. I'm gonna let that run for just a little bit and see if that pressure, my head pressure, don't rise some. Amp draw on my compressor, just under 10, and on the condenser fan motor, .9. All right, compressor, 21.4, outdoor fan, 1, so we're both are well within range. All right, we're getting close to 300, which is where I want it to be. It's still going up slowly. R410 running in heat without it being close to freezing outside. I do want to see that above 300. All right, we've got 303 on our head pressure. So I'm gonna test my defrost. And the way I do it, I pull that going to the condenser fan motor, which shuts it off. That way I'm testing my defrost sensors. One of these is my defrost sensor, this one, which goes inside and senses the temperature of the coil. And if it tells it it's freezing, and I test out these pins, which basically speeds up the timer, it should go into defrost. Not yet. Let's wait just a little bit longer. All right, there we go. All right, so when it goes into defrost, the condenser fan motor stops turning, and it's running in cool. So even though I got it jumped out right here to my blue, it's going to be running in cool, which heats up this coil, and if there's any ice on it, that helps it thaw out. Y'all see the steam coming off? That's because that coil is getting warm. Y'all see steam on a condenser like this? That's normal. I can't tell you how many times I've come out to a call where they say the fan stopped working and it was smoking. Well, no, it was going through defrost. Our pressures are back over 300. Yeah, this thing's doing good. I gotta check my bearings and remove any leaves that might be in there. That's good. I might just get that water hose and go ahead and wash this out. I put in a 5-ton the other day that was like this tall. Make sure your power is still on when you leave or turn back on. Now that outdoor coil did not need washing, but I did it anyway this time, but I don't always do that. If it don't need washing, I don't always do it. And if the indoor coil needs to be cleaned, we quote them a price. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll catch you on the next one.